Sleep in the Garden of Remembrance every night, because there's a little shelter in there where I could sleep in, and when I woke up every morning I could look at the clock and I'd know what time it was. And one of the nights, one of the pals that we were sleeping around here, we were sleeping in the hostel called Cedar House, and obviously we were doing drugs all day, and he was after doing a bit too many drugs, and we were both in the dormers, and he got into his bed, he was actually still wearing his clothes, and he put the duvet up to there. And I woke up the next morning and I looked at him and he was blue. He was dead. And then 2.5 weeks later, down at Christchurch, where Dublin is, where the arch is, there's a place I used to go under, down the spiral stairs to do me drugs. And there I found a lifelong friend from Blanchardstown, and he was dead. And he was there all night. All these deaths were completely covered up, completely wiped out. Nobody knew about them. Nobody. Nobody cared about the deaths that was going on. Everything was hushed up. And I seen it. When I was in the hostel, I couldn't get out of the hostel quick enough. And I haven't gone back there since. I couldn't. Seeing what they done, they got everybody out of the hostel so quick, covered everything up. You wouldn't see it in the newspapers. You won't see nothing. The homeless, they're all left on drugs. And when they're given the drugs, they're told, here's more drugs. There's more drugs for you. Just keep taking drugs. Go to Pier Street, see your doctor, and get a prescription, and get more drugs. That's what they're doing. My brother was 36 years of age, and he was going in, he was on 135 mils a day, and he was homeless. And they made, he was selling his foie every week for €500 to feed his habit. And he was taking his foie every day, and he took his gear that day, it was on a Monday, and he died on the train to Mayo from an overdose. This is what they're doing to the homeless. They're all pushed into this city and they're left dead. They're truly trying to kill them. They don't want to help them. They're not doing anything to help the homeless here, only to make you homeless and to put you into the system and to make you feel desperate and that you go crawling to them every time you feel sick to try and feel better. And this is the mind control that they have over people here and that are living on the streets. We have to help them. You know, it's not just coming here to help them. We really do. They need more support than anything. It's not going to Merchant's Quay so they can go and get a clean needle. That doesn't help them. That's enabling them. They're going to Pier Street to get their prescriptions filled out. And they're only being enabled. It's like, here's more drugs. Get the benzos into you. Get them into you. They'll keep you tied over. You won't feel sick. And while every tablet they take is every bit of soul being drained out of them. And that's what's happening. That's why I'm here, from my experiences from being homeless, you know? And we really do need to stand. I didn't get to see much of the budget, but was there anything in there for the homeless? Anything at all? Not even €1,000, nothing. Not a tent, nothing. No provisions for them. No funding for projects, absolutely nothing. They're all pushed into doorways and everything gets blocked up on them. Everywhere. Even when I was homeless here 20 years ago, they were putting things in places to stop people from sleeping where it was dry. I mean, how sad is that? Somewhere, someone wants to sleep somewhere dry, has to go, jump into the Stephen's Green and get under a bush for the night. Because believe me, that's what I had to do. And I've done it. And it's not easy. And it wasn't easy for me to come here today because of the memories I have on this street. But we have to come together. We really do. This country is fucked. And if people don't get up off their lazy holes and do something, everyone here will be homeless. We're all going to be sleeping under them bushes. Yep. But anyway, thanks for listening. Hopefully they might listen and learn something too. Because guys, we need your help. We need real Garda Síochána to protect us. Not protect the paedophiles in there. Protect us and our homeless and our own. Because Ireland is for the Irish.
That's right. That's it.
Yeah. Yeah.